वो बड़ा ग्रोह था
जी,
खरीन मिन आखरीन, आखरीन में से निस्बतन कम उस मरतबे के लोग हैं,
ठीक है,
उसके बावजूद उनमें ऐसे लोग थे
जी।
तो ये शर्तें बीच में शामिल हुआ करती है, मख्फी होती है,
ठीक है। ये बहुत एक मेरी अहम गलती थी जो मेरी समझ में आई,
लेकिन कितने मुरब्बियों से आप बात कर चुके हैं हराने के लिए उनको?
ये नहीं, हराने के लिए नहीं सर, जरूर इसने जो समझ नहीं आ रही,
मैं आपको जानता हूँ, बस चुटकुले छोड़ने की आपको आदत है, बस करें, काफी हो गया, दिल जीतने की कोशिश किया करें। तीसरा सवाल था जी, तीसरा क्या रहता है जी?
तीसरा सवाल हजूर ये
अव्वल तो मशवरा ये है कि तौबा कारी ले सवालों से,
ठीक है जी,
ऐसे सवाल अवैध कर लिया करें।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम हजूर, मेरा नाम मिर्ज़ा अख्तर बेग है, ज़िला कसूर लल्यानी मेरा गांव है।
हाँ, मैं जानता हूँ
हजूर, सवाल ये है कि हज़रत अली रज़ी अल्लाह ने दारुल खिलाफा तब्दील किया मदीना से कूफा ले आए, तो वो क्यों तब्दील किया और क्या वो वजूहात पूरी हो गई थी?
पढ़ा नहीं तारीख में क्यों तब्दील किया,
वो वजूहात उनकी जिंदगी में पूरी अगर नहीं हुई तो फिर पूरी हो गई थी तो फिर वापस क्यों नहीं आए मदीना?
हजरत अली रज़ी अल्लाह तआला ने इस बारे में कोई बयान दिया
नहीं?
बयान की जगह कैसे बयान दे दो अजीब बात कर रहे हैं आप, कुछ समझ के किया होगा, कुछ सोच के किया होगा, ऐसा सवाल जो उनके सामने पेश नहीं हुआ जिसका जवाब उन्होंने दिया, आप जमात अहमदिया के चौथे खलीफे से सवाल वो कर रहे हैं, अजीब बात है, 1400 साल बाद। अगला सवाल आगे आके बैठे हैं, लाइन में, लाइन में जो लोग बैठ चुके हैं उनकी बारी आ रही है, हैं? थोड़ा सा रास्ता क्या 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 कहना चाहते हैं?
इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन से सवाल
आ रहा। अच्छा, क्या सवाल है वो? हाँ, द इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग पीपल वांट टू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन, सम ऑफ देम आई मीन, प्लीज यू आर परमिटेड प्लीज। वालेकुम अस्सलाम रहमतुल्लाह, राइट,
in Australia, the society has been discussed so much.
I don't follow you. Maybe कौन समझ रहा है इसको? Excuse me, would you kindly speak more clearly because of some trouble in the system of communication? I couldn't follow you correctly. Speak slowly and clearly.
What is multicultural society? According to Islam,
what is
multicultural society?
Multicultural. I understand now. I've got it. What is multicultural society?
According to Islam,
right?
Yes. In Australia, multicultural society has been discussed so much. Some of the region feel unjust to be included in the multicultural society.
Yes, sir.
Being the first inhabitants in Australia,
right,
and to be treated the same with the new immigrants,
right.
This attitude also adopted by some white people,
right.
So any such concept in Islam?
I know what you're talking about. I have been confronted with this question in Europe repeatedly on different forums, and I spoke on this subject also during my address to Lajna Mahalla in one of their sessions only a month or two ago. There I made clear distinction between culture and cultural values and religion and religious values, as long as they do not clash with each other, there is no problem. Any man following a religion can adopt any culture as long as it does not stand at odds with the religion. But whenever there is a confrontation, then that part of the culture must be rejected by the Muslims. There the Muslims will have a counterpart as their cultural value. The culture is a very difficult word to explain, because from people to people, country to country, cultural habits and customs change. Anything which is not contrary to a religious teaching can be accepted and adopted, and there is absolutely no harm in doing that. But whenever religious values are attacked and are rejected or attempted to be changed and modified, there of course a Muslim would not take a step further in that direction, stop there and say, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلَيَ دِينُ. In that regard, to you belongs your faith and to me belongs my faith. Now this is a short answer, but if you want longer explanations and illustrations as to where the cultural values may differ and what a Muslim should do, you better have access to those cassettes, and inshallah, I hope your query will be satisfied.
As-salamu alaykum, Hazur.
Wa alaykum.
My name is Ali Murtaza, New York. I just wanted to say...
When did you arrive?
I'm sorry?
When did you arrive from New York?
Actually, I've been in Pakistan since the 14th of December, and I've been traveling between Islamabad, Rabwa, and now Qadian.
Right, right.
And I want to say that I am a living example of the answer of prayers, because I had no means whatsoever of coming to Jalsa other than just intent.
Right.
And in the very last moment, the intention was fulfilled by the graces of Allah.
Alhamdulillah.
I also want to say happy birthday to you. I understand you recently had a birthday.
Happy birthday? How many days after my birthday?
I don't know exactly, but I would say, a wild guess, about 6 days.
Right. You know, I was born on the 18th of December. You know that?
No, I didn't, but
But you just you guessed that perhaps I was born somewhere here.
Somewhere around here.
That's right. Yes.
Actually, in Grandpa, they remember this quite well, and
Jazakumullah, normally we do not celebrate birthdays. This is one of the illustrations of culture as against religious habits. Why we do not celebrate birthdays is because to be born on a day is just an accidental thing. It does not carry any message, and it does not signify either good or evil. That child who is born on a certain date, he may grow up into a rascal, into a wicked person, into a wanton man, who should have not been born if he knew, if he had any control over his own matter of his own birth. He would much rather not be born. Like Jesus Christ said, if somebody who does this, it would have been much better for him not to be born. So even that person also celebrates his birthday. So that is a strange thing. It is not, it does not coincide with human natural common sense. Again, when we consider that no prophet of God ever celebrated his birthday. No caliph of a prophet ever celebrated his birthday. Talking of the recent history of Ahmadiyya, Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam's birthday was never celebrated in his family. Either by his wife, his children, or any relatives, never.